Bim, guess what? We're back on Microsoft Flight Simulator in Late Night Gaming, where we're going to do some gaming that's late night gaming, starting with a flight simulator. This is my third go. First attempt, I just flew at night, got to the airport, and then crash landed in a field next to the airport. Second attempt, I flew over Wigan and then flew the route to my mother's house that I take every week, and was amazed at the detail that the game had. And tonight, I'm going to see if we can actually take off and land somewhere. I know, scary times ahead. So, for some reason my tablet's not working, so I will resort to the Mobi. And there I am. Oh, stupid thing. You're doing that for, go away. Oh no, it is that. I just never watch myself. Hello, person who weirdly uses their real name. You should be a bed asleep. Right then. So, let's see if not only can I land and take off, but if I can land and take off. Right, I've done 1 hour, apparently. I've got a hangar, I didn't know I had a hangar. What's that about? That's my Cessna. Change aircraft, X. Alright, okay. I'll go for a... Yeah, we'll have that. Okay. Go for that as well. Okay, so I'm happy now. So I've now got a Boeing 747. I couldn't fly a Cessna, what could possibly go wrong? Because all these have been scrapped now, haven't they? I don't pay £22.49 for a Lancaster. Right. That's that South Africa. That's India, I think. Yeah. It's Malaysia, and that's Australia. Means that is Queensland, so we'll go there. Right, and then we will only fly to there. It's 1,000 nautical miles. Hello, Toph. I'm a bit worried. I'm just about to take off in a Boeing 747.
Queenstown Tower, Boeing Alpha Sierra. 747 ready at runway 23 west departure. Calling Alpha Sierra. 747 altimeter 29er decimal 9er 21246 at 3. Departure to the west approved. Cleared for takeoff runway 23.
Cleared for takeoff runway 23, Boeing 747.
So I'm going to have to fly it. I have to drive it to the runway. Oh no, it's doing it for me. Right, okay. Go with throttle up. Is this runway long enough? Yeah, let's restart again.
Queenstown Tower, Boeing Alpha Sierra. 747 ready at runway 23 west departure.
Boeing Alpha Sierra. 747 altimeter 29er decimal 9er 21246 at 3.
Right. I go. Done that, so I've got a bit of acceleration. I'm trying to go up. Right. Right, I know what I'm doing now. I figured it out. So rev the engines up, then release the parking brake thing. Thing 140 we need to get to. Come on. Is it possible to actually take off from this airport? With this plane?
Queenstown Tower, Boeing Alpha Sierra. 747 ready for departure to the west at runway 23.
I learned something today. Can I go backwards? I can go backwards. Right, what I'm going to do is I'm going to get a different I still prefer Pilot Wings 64. No, Pilot Wings on the SNES was the best. Get a smaller plane. Change aircraft. Airbus, there you go. That'll do. That'll do, pig. That'll do. That will need as big a runway, will it? There you go. So, we give up with the 747, you've just joined us. We're now in an Airbus. That Tasmania, that is Tasmania, isn't it? Canberra. Melbourne. Melbourne International. Arrival, there you go. Right. Hi, John.
Queenstown Tower Airbus Alpha Sierra X-ray 320 ready. Right. Runway 23 west departure.
This will not need as much runway, but it's still a jet, so it'll still fly. Do this. Don't stall.
Airbus 320, continue for west departure. Queenstown Tower Airbus Alpha Sierra X-ray 320, continue for west departure.
Now, don't see if you live in New Zealand, you'd be like, oh my god, look at that, my house is there, look, that's the quarry I work in. Mario Plane 64. Yeah, this is it.
Sierra X-ray 320 is type Airbus A20 entry miles west of Queenstown, 3,500 feet. Request clearance to transition Charlie airspace.
Airbus Alpha Sierra X-ray 320 Queenstown approach. Squawk 3016.
Squawk 3016 Airbus 320.
Airbus 320 radar contact 4 miles west of Queenstown, 4,700 feet. Cleared through the Charlie airspace.
Cleared through the Charlie airspace, Airbus 320.
That's where we've come from. Or down there somewhere. Oh no, we come from over there. Good God, we're flying. What do you cruise at? There's going to be a lot of sea in this. Ladies and gentlemen, this is your captain speaking. I'd like to thank you to the second flight of Tech Airways. Today we are flying from New Zealand's airport to Canberra Airport in Australia. The flight will take approximately 15 hours. In that time we will be serving you with fresh drinks from your fridge. And if you fail to use the toilet, I'm sure you know where the bathroom is because you're in your house. If you're in a car, don't use the toilet. We're at 10,000 feet. How high did these things go? Around 25,000 to 30,000 feet. Oh, okay then. Well, I'm as angled as I can be. Remember when I used to fly a lot to from Manchester or Liverpool to Dublin? We'd literally be like that, and then next thing you know, we'd be pointing down again. It was like going zoom zoom.
129.3 Airbus 320. New Zealand Center Airbus Alpha Sierra X-ray 320, 11,600 feet.
Airbus Alpha Sierra X-ray 320, New Zealand Center Altimeter 29.92, continue as planned.
So they're happy with my flying. Very easily please these people, aren't they? So at 12,000 feet. Just joined us. This is my first flight in an Airbus. I've only used Cessnas before. It's only my third ever flight, and the other two have ended up with me crashing. I'm currently flying over New Zealand, heading towards Australia. It may take a while, so if you want to get a book, read a watch a movie, watch the Olympics, whatever, and I'll keep you informed as and when anything happens. We're still cruising up. We are currently at 14,500 feet. One reason I'm flying in Australia is and New Zealand is because it's daytime there. Because it uses the real time for the different parts of the planet. If you want to see me flying the route that I take when I go to my mother's in Wigan to Tameside and be gobsmacked at the detail, then there is a video up, which is basically I try and find my house, which I do, and then I fly to my mother's house, and I can't believe the detail, and it was amazing. So that's up there as well. Anyway, I'm not going to be landing this for a while, so I suggest either you keep watching and do something else in the meantime, or alternatively, just like, share, subscribe, well, don't prefer the like or share bit, subscribe, and then pop back in about three quarters of an hour and I'll let you know where I'm up to. Because this is going to be quite boring, I would have thought. Because I do intend to do this quite seriously. And it was 17,000 feet. Flying over some mountains. You know, you see an aeroplane in the sky, you think, that's not going very fast. Well, when I look down, we're not going very fast. Got 1,125 nautical miles, 24 nautical miles to go. Just angling a little bit so we can get it onto the... I'm only using a joypad as well, which I've got no batteries for, so I'm using it plugged in. It's not the best thing ever, but you know. Needs must and all that. Look like you've had a couple of drinks. No, I'm just knackered. Wouldn't be flying a plane drunk. That's what British Airways pilots do, allegedly. This is not British Airways, this is Teg Airlines. So I've got 550 knots and it doesn't seem fast when you're up there, that is true. I'm doing, I'm only doing 197. Maybe when I stop climbing, and I go straight, it'll speed up. Right. Yeah, there we go. Airspeed's going up now. Right, we're now cruising at 20,000 feet. I've overcorrected, haven't I? We're about to leave. The airspace. Of New Zealand. Trying to get back on that red, on that line, that's my flight path, I think. There we go. I think that's it. So there we go. Right, we're now serving drinks. So if you want to get yourself a drink from the trolley, and I'll try and keep the plane steady. We're now doing 237. Let's give it some welly. Is that as fast as this goes? Looks like it. Right, I think we're doing all right now. Trying to keep it on that flight path is a bit annoying. It's like being in a boat, you know, if you're on a boating lake and you're trying to park your boat. Oh, we're now 300 knots. So we're now leaving New Zealand. It's quite hilly, isn't it? Almost looks hobbitish. Not that I've ever seen the films, but I can imagine. Please be advised we are doing a course correction. This is so annoying. I'm trying to keep it straight. Right, so you have to do your manoeuvre before you're on the line. And then straighten it up. Right, we're now cleared. We're getting closer now, we're only 1,000 nautical miles. Try to keep on this line, because let's be honest, very soon there'll be very little to guide myself, because I'll be flying over the ocean. I think if you're in this plane, you'd be thinking you're on a roller coaster. But that's what Teg Airlines do. They give you the full experience. They'll swift you from side to side. Also make it go up and down like a roller coaster, so we keep you entertained.
Airbus 320, contact Auckland Center on 120.5. Good day.
Going to 120.5, Airbus 320. Auckland Center, Airbus Alpha Sierra X-ray 320, flight level 250.
Airbus Alpha Sierra, X-ray 320, Auckland Center, continue as planned. Come on, we can do this. I think we can do this. Oh, we're at 2,600 feet now. No, 25. Yeah, 2,600 feet, which is way too high. Turbulence? Got enough going on without turbulence, thank you very much. Don't seem to be getting any nearer to where we're going. Ain't that pretty? It's very pretty. So New Zealand now is a distant memory. Just hoping they put enough fuel in. I do worry about such things. So now we've got no landmarks to talk about, because let's be honest, well, be fair, there's no landmarks anyway. Even if I was flying over Australia, I wouldn't know where I were. All I watch is Aussie Opal Hunters and Aussie Gold Hunters. Getting exciting. Ooh, lens flare. It's like watching a Star Trek movie. You can get the light to shine through the windows. I said the light, it's the sun, isn't it? Right, so yeah, now there's, well, there's still a bit of land we can see back there because they were quite high mountains, but we are now flying inexorably into the void of the sea near Australia. Back on the line. How's it looking inside? Where's my co-pilot? Oh my god, why does my head turn all the way around? Where am I? These buttons do. Slightly frightening me that. Apart from that, there's no pilot.
Overspeed. Overspeed.
What?
Overspeed. Overspeed. Overspeed.
Overspeed. Overspeed. What does that mean? Am I going too fast? I don't think there's speed cameras around here. I think we'll be alright. That was like a publicity shot, doesn't it? Buy our plane. It's great. Buy our plane, we'll take you to the moon. Oh, we're under 1,000 nautical miles now. That's good. What's wrong with overspeed then? What is wrong with overspeed? Sure, this would be easy with a keyboard. Right, should be no land anywhere now. Nope, just got the sea. And the fishes. And the sky. With the sun and the moon. Do you know the moon's upside down in Australia? And they think it's upside down when they come here. Mad. Ladies and gentlemen, if you'd like to look out of your left window, you'll see the ocean and the curvature of the Earth. If you want to look out of the right window, you will see the ocean and the curvature of the Earth. Ooh. And some weird thing going on the... the ground, or is that what you can see through the sea? Maybe they've even mapped under the water. If you press down on the right analog stick, it puts you back into this position, so you can look around and then just press the right analog stick, puts you back. I've only learned that tonight. Alright, so automatic pilot is currently flying us. Alright, okay. It's taking us higher up. Look, it's taking us... Oh, we're doing vapor trail. Oh, that's cool. That's very impressive. No, I'm just playing it on whatever it started off at, but it is on the Series X, and it is thinking of Bobby, innit? Right, we're at 30,000 feet. You're going to stop now? Yeah. What did we say it was before? Around 25,000-30,000 feet. Well, the automatic pilot is taking us higher. We've stopped doing the... oh no, we haven't. We're still doing the vapor trail. Suppose the higher up you are, the faster you go. Oh, away of course. Autopilot was rubbish. Mind you, last time I used an autopilot, or saw an autopilot being used, was on in the movie Airplane. And he got a puncher. Didn't end well. Yeah, I went way too far that way, didn't I? Trying to find a charge cable. Won't fit. Oh, going way off course. I'm having a disaster of my own kind here. Gentlemen, please put down your drinks. So we are going to try and get back on track. Sounds different up here, doesn't it? Oh. Seems a lot quieter than it was before. Oh no. Try to get back on that red line. I'm using fuel as well and everything. It's just going horribly wrong. Right, that should, we should rejoin because we're going at a slight angle. Right, we're about a quarter of the way there now. can go straight through the vapor trail. There you go, there's your publicity shot, Airbus. Right, I told you we'd be getting back on. So now we just angle it a little bit. A little bit more. And that should bring us into line with it. There you go. Get a bit more. Ladies and gentlemen, we have experienced a bit of turbulence. However, the airspeed is 264 knots. No, it's 250 knots, sorry. And we are currently at 34,900 feet. We hope you're enjoying your flight. A reminder that refreshments are in your fridge. Biscuits are available if you have some in your kitchen. We thank you for flying Teg Airlines. I'd like to draw your attention to the view from the left window, which is of the seeing the sky, and from the right window as well, which is seeing the sky. Unbeatable fuel energy. The fuel efficiency, it says, on the side of that. Okay. Right, we're bang on the line. And we're... yeah. We're definitely at least quarter of the way there. What's that hole for there? Because them are the engines, and that's the exhaust from the engines. So what's that? What's that hole for?
Airbus 320, you're leaving my airspace radar service. Terminated squawk 7000. Frequency change approved.
Squawk 7000. Frequency change approved. Airbus 320. Brisbane Center Airbus Alpha Sierra X-ray 320 is type Airbus A20 and flight level 355. Request flight following.
Airbus Alpha Sierra X-ray 320 Brisbane Center. Squawk 1013.
Squawk 1013 Airbus 320.
Airbus 320 radar contact flight level 355.
Roger Airbus 320.
So I thought this plane was a bit quiet. Now we know why. Can you imagine trying doing this in the Cessna? A, it will take 15 but you can't walk through the plane when autopilot takes over. Imagine doing the Cessna. Oh no, we've run out of fuel. But it's took us 5 hours to get this far. Bear in mind, in Cessna we were doing less than 100 knots. We're in for the long haul here, guys. Well, it's 800 miles, 800 nautical miles now, so it's going down. Remember, it was, I think, 1300 to begin with. I'm actually doing very manual. So we're at 35,700 now. On the roller coaster again. Right. Concentrating like crazy here. How long before we see land? I mean, I've never been in a plane where you kind of surrounded by the sea. Basically certain death if anything goes wrong. Make sure to breathe. This is ATC. You folk detected at 30,000 feet. On the roller coaster again. I think with it turbulence because I can't keep the plane straight or level. Okay then. I don't know what turbulence is, but I know it's a nightmare for people. Right, let's get back on track before we worry about that. Right. What's going on with the altitude? The altitude is doing my nutting. I've had better days, I've had worse days. Weekend hype, don't get weekend hype when you work in a shop. Oh, this is so complicated. Just press that. It's still sending us higher up, the automatic pilot. Oh, it's like it's bringing us down. Nine nautical miles. Right. There you go. We're on it. We're off it. We've gone over it. Now we're on it. Running parallel. Oh no, it's not got off again, is it? No, it's not got off again. Breaking up. So why has it done that? Got a bit of breakage then. I think I'm still streaming. Oh, bam, after all this. Having a technical hiccup here. I'm now looking at a completely different screen. But my phone, everything froze then, so I do apologise. Seems to be back on again. Yeah, I'm still streaming, yeah. Are we going up again? Why are we going up again? Yeah, literally. In the middle of nowhere. Get the wings straight. There we go. There's nothing to go off, is there? At all, apart from your map thing. There's not a lot going on the map. Ugly. Why is the plane so keen on me being at 36,000 feet? I don't understand. We've had a lot of lagging going on. It says 33% of this is lagged, which is a bit annoying. Kilobytes per second, 8,129. CPU is on 27%. It's been live for 1 hour 15 minutes. Drop frames, they are going down now. So hopefully whatever it was, sword. Why is the controller making buzzing noise? Oh, right, that's why. We're a bit high. Right, I don't know what's going on here. So it's excellent. Oh God. So 36,000 is where it wants to be then. We are going very up and down at the minute. That's not good for anyone. Right, give up with my phone. I think it's the phone that's causing the problems. Turn that off. Let's go back in. Good thing about this game is that I'm not losing any action. Lagging again. Why is it lagging? Right, now it's working again. No flying it in the OBS window, which does make life a bit tricky. Right, ladies and gentlemen, we're going on the roller coaster again. Humble apologies. Oh, we're going red again. We're having technical issues, ladies and gentlemen. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to see if I can stop it and start it again. See if that works. Say in excellent condition. it's not excellent condition at all. It's rubbish condition. I've restopped. I stopped and started. OBS. So we'll just see if that makes a difference. Just let me know if it has. Right, we're now trying to fly back parallel with the red line. Still leaving a vapor trail everywhere. So is that working better now? Yeah, it's still lagging a bit, but it does seem a little bit better than it was. Oh, I've gone. It's like I send it too far one way, then I send it too far the other way. Like, ah. Oh. Got my phone on using 4G rather than using the internet in the house. It's quite difficult to do this with a controller. But I'm not going to the expense of buying one of them £300 bloody yoke things and all that crap. Because I'll play this game for about a week and then that'll be it, then I'll never play it again. Because let's be honest, it can be quite boring at times. Do it with very delicate manoeuvres. Right, so we're running parallel with the line now. We need to be on it. How long have we got? So we're more than halfway there now. OBS I dropped. I shut the OBS program down and then reopened it again. which is extreme. Hell, there's not else I can do. You're so good to me, I don't need nobody, don't need no one, you're so good to me. We're making more, we are making more vapor here, aren't we? Oh, away of course. How's that happened? So annoying. Fair, I could do that. I don't think this would take that long, I'll be honest. But as we've already verified, I don't really fly a lot. Reset that now. Right, it seems to be working better now. Attempt fate or anything. Just do something as well. There you go. A bit better what I'm looking at. Oh. Just dropping the plane down. Oh, we can fast forward it. Yes, please. I don't know if you could do that.
Adjustment Center Airbus Alpha Sierra X-ray 320 is type Airbus A20 and 1,900 feet. Request.
Airbus Alpha Sierra X-ray 320 Brisbane Center. Squawk 0023.
Squawk 0023 Airbus 320.
Airbus 320 radar contact 900 feet. Altimeter 29er decimal 902.
Roger Airbus 320.
Drop down to 2,000 feet now. So I can only assume that Brisbane is on the coast. I'll let the autopilot take us to the right altitude and then I'll take control back again, because I've never done a descent and I've never landed one of these. I want to be in the white bar.
Overspeed.
It'll shut up in a second.
Overspeed.
No, shut up now.
Overspeed.
Shut up now.
Overspeed.
Shut up now.
Overspeed. 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 Overspeed.
Alright, now it shuts up. 400 miles. I'm now flying at the slowest I can fly. Hopefully, speed-wise, we're in the green. Let's press that and see what it would do with the... It's powering us up. Why is it doing that? Alright, okay, now it's slowing down again. Right, so 3,500 feet at 250 nautical kilonauts. Where's the moon gone? Well, there it is. So we're at 3,600 feet, and we're doing 247 knots. And we're bang on the red line as well. Which we weren't when it relocated me here, but I've managed to get back on the line, so we're doing okay. Very calm the sea, isn't it? Just like none of my passengers. So coming into land now. Let's be honest, landing is not my strong point. 247 knots is 284 miles an hour. What? Don't they measure knots by having a rope with a knot every yard or something, and they chuck it out the back, and then however many it pulls out of your hands, that's how fast you're going or something daft like that. Is that what they do on ships? I don't think a rope, I'm getting a rope out of a plane would be a good idea, actually, thinking about it. So 408. It's going down. Go. Got off a little bit. Got a ticket to the moon. Well, I'm flying to the moon anyway. This is your captain speaking.
Ugh, isn't it?
Must be 350 now. Oh no, 390. Oh yeah, because it was 400 and odd, wasn't it? I thought it was. Approach. Let's go to approach. I want to go to bed before Christmas. X is brake. Right, remember X is brake. Oh, we're over it now. Whoa.
Over speed. Over speed. Over speed. Over speed. Over speed. Over speed.
The hell's it doing?
Jetstar 433, follow the generic on final. Wind 25, 8 to 3. Clear to land runway
3, 4. Alright, okay.
Airbus 320, follow the aircraft on final. Wind 25, 8 to 3. Clear to land runway 3, 4.
Clear to land runway 3, 4 Airbus 320. Melbourne Tower Airbus Alpha Sierra X-ray 320 is 3 miles southeast, 3,600 feet within range to land.
Right, so that's what we need to fly into, is it? Too fast though, so we'll slow down again. So we're now flying over Melbourne. Yeah, long distance is probably alright if you're on your own and, you know, maybe fly a long distance if you're in the house all day, but do housework in between. Too fast, slow down, slow down, slow down. The runway there. So this is basically the flying over Staley Vegas bit. So whenever I go visit my mum, before all this happened, the plane's flying over all the time, and they're roughly about this height. You can see the, you know, the name of the. Well, you can tell the colours of it, stuff like that. Right, will I actually land my first plane ever? Too slow. There's the runway. Not going too fast, make your bloody mind up.
Jetstar 433 exit, runway with Naval.
Oh.
Over Overspeed. 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 Overspeed.
Jetstar 433 exit. Runway with Able.
Put the landing gear, right? What are you writing?
500.
Going around Airbus 320.
121.7. Jetstar 433.
Right. Good news is we didn't crash. Bad news is we didn't land. Right. Try again. Look, a racetrack thing down there. Right, try again. I know what I'm doing this time. I'm actually bricking it. Da 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 da. I'm bricking it. So I'm not careful, we're going too slow. Told you. Warning, 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 too slow, warning, 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 too fast. I'd like to thank you for flying Tech Airlines today. We've managed to get to Australia, so if you look out the window you can see Australia. That's the last thing you see before we crash, so you might as well enjoy the view and at least know that you got here. Warning, warning, warning. This is a much better way of landing us than the other ones were. Like, at least you can see the runway and everything. I think people in the camera would be like, oh my god, that's a freeway, and there's a junction, and there's this, that, and the other, and whatever. Oh, there's Avondale Heights, there's Essen West. Warning. Again. Just gliding now. Come on.
100.
Come on, land.
40. 20.
Five. Bit bumpy. Put my brakes on. Dead stick landing. After receiving landing clearance, switch off engines. I don't want to go too fast. I believe you. Well, thank you for the round of applause. It's got to be an easier way than this. Steering this is like steering something on ice. Come on. Don't crash into the truck now. Don't crash into the truck now. Come on, you can do this. Even the pilot doesn't have to do this. I'm gonna hit that truck, unless it's just there for sure and I can go through it. Oh no, it's... Yeah, it's alright, isn't it? 0.34 nautical miles. Radio, where's radio? What? don't know what I'm meant to do. Tune ATC radio to ground and request taxi clearance. So,